We are all here for nice work. We are not here to lazy ourselves. We are here to do hard work. Hard work on ourselves, not on work on others. The hard work is observing the breath, our own breath. When we observe our own breath, we observe ourselves. We keep ourselves calm and cool. We observe everything calmly and coolly. What a great thing it is. We should always be in that temperament. Everyone needs to be in that temperament. We have to keep our mind in cool, collected place. Always. Never should it be turbulent. When we are with the breath, the mind becomes non-turbulent. That is the law. That is the universal law. That's why we have to spend a lot of time with the mind in non-turbulence. Then that will become a habit. We are naturally grounded in ourselves. We are naturally grounded in our grand self. That is becoming enlightened. Becoming grounded in the grand self, which is universal self of everybody. There is only one universal self of everybody, which is the grand self. You have to stay put within that grand self, that grand ocean, which is not a drop. There you find fulfillment. Whatever small issues come in day to day, they become nothing in front of the ocean, or ocean of consciousness. You will be easily riding them, surfing them. That's what it is.
If our state of being changes, then we are automatically able to experience life more. the state of being towards what you're looking to experience, can be defined as poverty conscious or prosperity consciousness. Prosperity consciousness and poverty consciousness, prosperity and poverty. If our approach towards anything that we're looking to experience, anything, prosperity and poverty, and then I look at it and say, what do I carry? What do I carry in my life? What approach am I carrying towards that experience? The first thing is, if we have a prosperity consciousness, then we are deeply interested in that experience to have. It's called passionate desire. Deeply interested to have that experience to us. If it's poverty consciousness, then we are asking for it because people around are asking for it. Prosperity consciousness, you want to have that experience because you know that gives you happiness and you are seeking to it. Poverty consciousness, you are influenced through the others and so they're asking for it. Although you yourself may not necessarily have any interest at all. You yourself do not have any interest. You want it because you don't have it. It's that typical, look at that. You want something because you feel you don't have it. So there's a difference in how we approach something. You feel you don't have, and so then you ask for it, versus that is poverty conscious. Prosperity conscious, you feel it's going to give me deep happiness, and I've got this passionate desire. I want to experience it. I don't care what it is. I want to experience it. I like it. I see it. I like it. So you're attached to the feeling. Then you're analyzing, I don't have, so I think it's good to have for me because I don't have it. Prosperity consciousness is when you see somebody who has it, you're very happy. When you see somebody who has it, you're very happy. Poverty conscious is when you see somebody who has it, whatever that you like, experience you want to have, they are getting it, they have it. Then you feel despair, you feel sad, you feel low. Oh, when will I have it? They're lucky. That's poverty consciousness. They're lucky. I don't know when I can have that. But if you see when somebody has got it, feeling happy for them and say, wow, this is great. I see it. You walk up to them and congratulate them. You go and then look for that by talking to them more. That's prosperity. It's very important in the way we approach our situations. It doesn't matter. It's about seeking enlightenment. It's about wanting to have several experience in meditation. When somebody shares, I don't ever get these. I don't know when I'll even get it at all, meditation experiences. Versus, man, these guys are having so many experiences. They seem to have a ball on this here. Let me pick up a phone, talk to them, and then appreciate them and say, wow, this is beautiful. You're enjoying your journey. The difference is that in prosperity, we feel others experience our experiences, basically. in poverty consciousness, we are separate. And so we feel, I don't have. And then so I don't know when I'll get it. And then, oh, I feel despair. Prosperity consciousness sees that giving and receiving is equal. Giving and receiving is equal. In poverty consciousness, only one way. Either we have struggled to ask somebody, suppose. A lot of times we are ready to share, ready to give knowledge, ready to give what we have, giving. But we have difficulty in asking. We have asked a question to get clarification, we have difficulty. We don't ask. When we need help, we don't ask. Something stops us. There are either because of egoistic reasons, because of shy reasons, feeling, looking bad, fear of looking bad. And deep inside, something is blocking us from asking. We are ready to give, but we don't ask. In some cases, we keep asking, we're not ready to give. Keep taking, taking, taking from others. We are not ready to share. Energy is uniformly, it is the life flow of giving and receiving must be equal. They are the two parts of it. And so having one-sided, that I give, I cannot ask. I keep taking, but I don't give. Either way, so prosperity consciousness is maintaining it in balance. You don't have any hang-ups in asking. You can be a big leader, doesn't matter. But you need help, then you go and then ask. Doesn't matter. So we are giving and receiving balance is prosperity consciousness. Making it one way is poverty consciousness. We got to look at our approach. The fourth thing, or another point in poverty and prosperity is when you look at people who are very successful, when you hear autobiographies, inspirational stories, you read a newspaper clipping about somebody suddenly saying, hey, the company succeeded, or no, they have gotten this, or no, they're able to, at the very young age of 25, they became enlightened, they gotten this experience, they were able to do this. When you hear people who are very successful in general, what is that you're feeling? Do you feel great for them? Or do you feel somewhere sadness, somewhere low? Do you feel, wow, here is another consciousness who is able to now achieve something, experience something more? And do you feel that way for them? Or do you feel sadness? Do you feel low? Thinking that, I don't know, will I ever have it? My life is like this. I am stuck in this. You know, people are going forward in their lives in many different ways. But I'm here. I'm struggling to meet my ends. Prosperity is to feel that appreciation, feel that joy. When your neighbors, when your community, when your colleagues, when they have something, something new experience, they're having it. Appreciation, natural joy, congratulating them, if you know them, right? Any of these are prosperity. Poverty is to feeling low and sad. Another thing. Prosperity consciousness is you are joyful when you are attending to your day-to-day things. How are you approaching life? You receive a phone bill, you receive a more telephone bill, you receive an electricity bill, you receive a bill from a service vendor. When you're doing things, are you feeling, oh, so this is so expensive? you send your car to the dealer, and then the dealer sends back and says, okay, 20,000 rupees, it's so expensive. Oh man, these guys are just ripping me apart. Poverty consciousness. Prosperity consciousness, okay, I recognize it. I thank them for the service they've given me. I'm happy about it. And then you are giving without having any opinion about it. Instead, you feel happy. If you feel even more happy for getting the service. And so you're able to do that. That's the approach towards life's events, day-to-day events. That's prosperity consciousness. Thanking for service. Here, having that bias, having that opinion, oh, this is expensive. This got very expensive. Last year, I only paid 10K. This time, I'm paying like 20K for the same thing. People are somewhere are taking advantage of it. Think about how we approach everyday situation. We go to the market to buy vegetables. Oh, really? Onions are 50 rupees a kg? Bad. So expensive. Inflation is going up. Many, many big words. So poverty consciousness. Basically, there is always exchange is happening. You know, one person, Patri, there is a concept, maybe that loss and gain. One person's loss is another person's gain. Always. There is always some loss in one side, there's gain on the other side. And in the concept of spirituality, we're all the same, we're all one. If it is going from me, it's going to who else is going to? It's going from one pocket to another pocket. When we embrace the wholeness, when we embrace the oneness, we stop thinking this way, that I'm squeezed, I'm exploited, I'm being done this and I'm being done that. But day-to-day things, we're talking about normal day-to-day things. What is your approach? Are you staying happy and positive and then being able to deal with them, or are you always looking for things that are not working that great? It is the extrapolation of a half glass is half empty and half full. It's really that. Poverty consciousness. Another thing, poverty consciousness is when things happen to you, are you appreciating them? Are you expressing gratitude? Gratitude. When you get something into your life, you appreciate it. Are you in a state of gratitude for everything that you have and everything you're receiving? Or that's prosperity. Poverty is you don't even care about what you have, not grateful to whatever you have it today. And often we're feeling like given a raw deal. They're typically marked by complaints. Typically, this state is marked by complaints. That's not working, this is not there, it's been challenging, it's been tough life, it's been this, that, compliance. A poverty consciousness is marked by compliance. You're not grateful to what we have, and instead you are complaining. Of course, one principle we say is the prosperity consciousness is you're aligned to the universal principles of oneness. We are under the principles of oneness. You feel that we're all connected. We're all there. That is prosperity consciousness. In poverty consciousness, we are in this separate illusion of separateness. Oh no, I'm different. I am this and you are that. People are different. People are separate. We have this illusion that we are separate. And so then we have this affinity and say, okay, I am this religion. I'm this community. I'm this. There is always this affinity towards particular thing we attach to it. We are fanatic about it. A community, a race, or a caste, or a, you know, something we have. When we have those, we are, there is a fundamental feeling of separateness, embracing others versus being in one state. Poverty, consciousness. With our regular meditation, we are developing, we are moving away from poverty consciousness to prosperity consciousness. We're moving away from it. We start feeling wholeness. We get inspired when we hear other success stories. When we hear, we get inspired by default. Wow, this is good. One more person, really? That's amazing. We develop our gratitude. We start counting our blessings, and then we start looking at things in many, many ways. In a positive way, we start being grateful for things that we have, things that we're experiencing. We stop shying away. We stop that thing that stops us from asking for help. Abundance is the equal flow of receiving and giving are equal. So we start asking, we start expressing. And where we were not sharing before, now we start sharing our gifts, however little that is. It's natural. With meditation, we develop that state of, you know, having equal asking and receiving, equal flow, inflow and outflow, equal. The flow of abundance is always equal. We must develop this. Then we are we are happy that, you know, when somebody received it, we are happy. For them, whatever that specific experience you're looking for, when somebody received it, you're very happy about it. And then you are, when you're looking for something, when you ask for something, you're asking because you're passionate. You no longer ask for things just because people have it. Oh, they have it, I don't have it, so let me ask for it. There's never that. Instead, you're only very clear what you're passionate about is what you ask. The last thing, dear friends, is that in prosperity consciousness, we are recognized and we're always in the state of abundance that everybody has got. There is infinity out there for me to experience it. Infinity out there for everybody equally. There is any amount of resources, any amount of opportunity, because unlimited field of possibilities that, you know, everybody can get what they want. That's the prosperity. That is this attitude that we carry. Rather than competing, rather than going after thinking that, oh, there is only limited seats, there are only limited reservation, there are only limited market size, limited, that is poverty. And so then we don't try to compete and sort of say, I'm going to get what I want. I'm there. It's going to come to me. All I have to do is to ask for it. And so that is abundance. We stay of abundance always, that there's infinity for everybody. When we, our meditation is developing us into this, developing all these aspects into our daily life. And in case we're not there, we start looking at, introspect, reflect on it, and we develop those aspects. So let's go into our meditation, dear friends, today. Once again, like a long meditation. Continuing the week theme. It so happened that we have covered several points around manifestation. So we will do a manifestation meditation on this Sunday. And our meditation is simple. You do heart elevation and you do Anapanasati meditation. And then we have a segment to visualize and dream about a future in a very happy state. When we are empty-minded, we are happy. We are in the place of creation. So there we will visualize and connect with our future. We affirm your goals, affirm any empowering beliefs that you have, and then you visualize and dream about the future as if the goals have happened. That mind movie that you may have constructed during the week, or the mind movie that you always had that you are dreaming about in a larger group, you dream about and visualize, you know, your feeling. Your goals have happened, and so now we visualize about that future. We covered this earlier in maybe Thursday, Friday sessions of this week, what it means to visualize, what it means to set goals. In case anybody new can refer back to this week's sessions. And so we do that. So visualize and dream about a future. And then we take quick short breaths and then we lie down, and then we come out expressing gratitude. And friends, that's the process of meditation. Relax yourself, sit comfortably. It's a long meditation. It's going to end around in about 1 hour, 5 or 1 hour, 10 minutes is the time for this meditation. So relax yourself, sit comfortably. With your eyes closed, relax your body. Scan your body from head to toe. And relax.
Dear friends, dear masters, keep your hands on your chest area. Rest your attention on your sacred heart. Take a slow, long, relaxing breath. You feel your beautiful heart. With that breath energy, breathe more. And feel your beautiful heart, that seat of all emotions. Primary connection into this universe, which is expanding all life with its love energy, with its gratitude energy. Can you feel love, gratitude inside your beautiful heart? Relive a feel more of that love energy, of that gratitude energy, and expand your heart center. We're all connected in this universe. Deep inside, we are specks of energy. Intricately connected with each other. The nature of this universe is to bring coherence and order among all things and everybody with love, with compassion, with gratitude, appreciation. There is only one life, there is only one heart. Can you feel the love inside your beautiful heart? Become one with all things and everybody. Can you radiate that energy beyond your body? Unto every being of this planet Earth, where your attention goes, there the energy flows. Feel the love, that gratitude inside you, all around you. Friends, let's go into breath mindfulness meditation. with your fingers into fingers. Rest your hands comfortably in your lap with your eyes closed, specs removed. Observe your normal, natural in-breath and the out-breath. We're all going into powerful group meditation.
Thank you.
observe your normal, natural, peaceful in-breath and the out-breath, dear friends. Our goal is to empty your mind. Our goal is to merge into that greater emptiness, our divine self. As we empty our mind, when we observe our breath, our mind becomes empty. Meditation is the greatest gift that we give to ourselves. This time is for ourselves, that is yourself, to completely forget everything about yourself and simply observe your natural, normal in-breath and the out-breath, dear friends. Be with your breath. to slowly and slowly become empty of all thoughts in your mind. Thank you. All emptiness is energy. That's energy in the quantum field with unlimited possibility and opportunity. Become aware of that emptiness, of nobody, of nothing, of no one, in no place and no time. Yourself to go beyond your body, way beyond your life. And merge into this emptiness as no one, as pure awareness. This is the place of unknown. Allow yourself to stay connected with this emptiness, with this energy. The longer we stay in this unknown, the more open we become to many possibilities in our life. And the more we receive from it. Thank you. stay aware of this emptiness as no body and tune in to the abundance of healing energy, mystical energy, miraculous energy, empowerment energy, or whatever that you can become aware of in this field.
Friends, it's time to step into your future. It's time to walk into your new future. Come on, it's time to create that future, dear friends. Come on, I want you to affirm your goal. I want you to affirm whatever that you want to become at this time with heightened feelings and emotions into this universe, dear friends. Remember, this is the time to create your new future with heightened feelings, emotions, and clear thought and intent. Whatever we emotionally embrace, whatever we put in very clearly, must manifest in this outer reality. Come on, I want you to affirm your goal. Let this quantum field know that this is important for you. Come on, affirm your goal with that emotion. And as you affirm that goal, do you have any empowering beliefs for this goal? Come on, affirm them one by one with heightened feelings, with heightened emotion into this field at this time. I want you to feel that empowering belief. I want you to believe in that empowering statement that you're no longer limited by your old self, that you are defined by this new empowering, supporting belief for that future. Come on, affirm your empowering beliefs one by one at this time. And as you affirm your empowering beliefs, dear friends, now I want you to create that future. I want you to walk into that new future as if that goal has already happened for you. At this time, come on, I want you to live that future right now as if it's happening for you. Experience that future with heightened emotion, with clearer intent and heightened feelings, my friend. Come on, I want you to live every part of your mind moving. I want you to live every bit of that new future, each and every experience of that new future right now, as if it's happening for you, dear friends. Remember, this future is already exists in this quantum field as waves of possibilities. With your observation, with your heightened feeling and heightened emotion, you can draw that future into your physical reality. Come Come on, dear friends. Come on, experience that future by reliving every part of your mind movie. Come on, what choices will you make in this new future? What things will you do in this future, dear friends? What experiences are awaiting you? Come on, how will they feel? I want you to feel. I want you to experience every bit of that future, dear friends. This new future, parts that you can think at this time, whatever experiences that you can have at this time, dear friend, they have to become the blueprints of your future. Friends, do you have a new body in this future? Come on, feel. I want you to experience that body. I want you to enjoy that body, dear friends. How does it feel to be with that body? Did you want to do that track? Do it now. Come on, feel every part of the body. Where are you traveling in this new life? Come on, feel that place. Feel the warmth of the people. Feel the beauty of the place of the nature around you. Dear friends, what are you going to do with this new life? What are you going to do when you are healthy? Come on, imagine. I want you to dream. Let your imaginations flow. The more you can experience that new future, the more you can experience that heightened emotions of love, of gratitude, compassion, kindness, appreciation. Dear friend, the more you signal the universe to create the future for you. Is yours. You are the architect of your new life. Let there be no doubt. Let there be no uncertainty. Whatever you emotionally embrace, dear friends, must manifest into your outer reality. Come on, believe in the process. Our thoughts and our feelings create our outer reality. That is law. That is quantum law. By mentally rehearsing what the future will be like, you are priming your brain and body to make it look like this future is already happened for you. Come on, feel it. I want you to experience that new body. I want you to experience that new life to whatever, wherever you're traveling. How are you making your decisions in this new life? Come on, feel that confidence in you. Come on, feel it. What are people telling you in this life? Come on, dear friends. Feel their appreciation. Feel that recognition for your work. Come on, how does it feel to be recognized by you, to be appreciated by people around you? Friends, How are you liking your new job or the business? Come on, feel it, experience every bit of that new job, that new business, or whatever that you've taken now. Who is benefiting from you in this new future, dear friends? Come on, feel their gratitude towards you. Come on, how does it feel to help somebody out there? Come on, feel your kindness. Feel your compassion towards them, dear friends. Feel it. Come on, the more you experience their emotion of love, of gratitude, of kindness, of joy, dear friends, the more you create, the more you draw that future towards you in your physical reality. Come on, feel more. I want you to live more of that future. Let there be no doubt. I want you to focus. I want you to experience every bit of that mind moving. Come on, the more you can feel it, the more you can love it, the more you can enjoy it, and the more you can experience it, dear friends, the more faster you can manifest this reality into your life. Friends, this is the time to create the future. This is the time to visualize. This is the time to dream every part of the future as if it's happening for you right now. The more you can rehearse this future, the more you can experience the future ahead of it actually happening, dear friends. We are signaling this quantum field strongly to manifest it for us in our reality. The stronger you're feeling, the stronger you're signaling your genes in the body to upregulate and repair whatever that you need to, dear friends. Feel it. I want you to believe in this future. I want you to experience this future. Stay connected with this future, dear friend, and enjoy it. The more you can live it, the more you can love it right now, and the more you can invite that future into your life at this time, dear friends, the more you signal this quantum field. Come on, live those choices that you make in this new future. Whatever you wanted to do in this future, come on, experience it now. Dear friends, let those thoughts and images come. They have to become the blueprints of your new future. Whatever you want to do with that new world, with that new job, with that new freedom, with that new life, dear friends, feel it. I want you to live it. I want you to experience it. Remember, the more you can experience this future now, dear friends, the stronger you signal this quantum field, the stronger you signal your genes. remember that whatever you emotionally embrace, this must manifest into outer reality. Feel, love. Relax yourself and let's surrender our future created with that new body, with that new mind, into this universe, for it knows best the right time and place to bring that future into our life. Let's let this body synthesize the energies into the system as we relax. I want you to breathe with me and lie down after that. Come on, breathe with me. Breathe in through your nose and breathe out through the mouth. 10 short breaths, let's go. Hold it, hold the breath for 5 seconds, hold it, exhale, relax, feel that energy in your brain, relax, and as you relax, quickly, I want you to lie down. Lie down, dear friends. Whoever want to continue in your chair, you may continue, so just lie down on the floor, on the bed, on your back, and feel the weight of your body and rest yourself in a comfortable posture as you lie down. Observe your in-breath and the out-breath. Observe that breath. Find that emptiness inside you, all around you, as you become one with your breath. And as you become empty, as you're finding emptiness, I want you to drift away and be a witness. As you drift away into this infinity of that emptiness, be still and drift away. Find that emptiness inside you as you observe your breath all around you, and slowly drift away and be a witness. To that experience as you drift away into that infinity.
Oh.
come back to your body. Stay where you are. Come back to your breath. With your eyes closed, stay where you are. Come back to your body. Place your hands over your heart. Place your hand over your heart. And bless your body with a new mind. Bless yourself with that new body and the new mind. Your body is a temple, so bless it and love it into a new life created by this new body and new mind. Bless your past that it turns into wisdom, that you are no longer limited by that old emotion, by that old self. Bless your future, that it be filled with opportunity and adventure. Bless the challenges in your life, that they initiate you into greatness, that the deeper meaning of all challenges be revealed to you. Bless the divine power within you. Ask it to move in you, move through you, move around you, and ask it to show evidence that this new future be real in your outer life. Express gratitude, but gratitude is the ultimate state of receivership. The longer we feel gratitude for this new future created by this new body and mind, the more we are drawing that future into our lives. Because gratitude means that event has already happened. Open your hearts and express the deep gratitude to your parents, to your teachers and mentors. Be grateful to all the people in your life, your family, your friends, relatives, colleagues, everybody. Be grateful to this grand nature, the bird, the fish, and the animals, our sun, the moon, the earth. Be thankful to all the things in our life, the places we visit, the companies and governments, and various people. Be grateful to yourself, for this intelligent universe, for allowing us to create this magnificent future, to be an integral part of our lives. Gratitude is an ultimate state of receivership. Thank you.
Relax yourself. Feel your body. And relax your body. And as you relax, recollect your experience from the session. How did you feel? Who have you become? What did you experience? And whenever you're ready, keep your hands on your eyes for 5 seconds and then open your eyes.
My dear friends, take your time to settle down. Hope you all had a wonderful session today. So there are two types of creation. One is deliberate creation and default creation. And through manifestation, we are doing that deliberate creation, whatever the reality that we wanted to have in our life. And it's really nice with Chandrasar's wisdom today, poverty consciousness and prosperity, coupled with wonderful meditation. So, dear friends and masters, how was the experience today? Anyone would like to share your experience? Or any questions, any clarifications? How did you felt today? Anyone would like to express? Raise your hand in the Zoom session. In the Zoom. Being aware of this prosperity, the poverty consciousness is very, very important personally. Yes, myself, that's what I felt it. Yes. Yes, Anushama. Yeah.
Thanks, everyone. It's really wonderful meditation. It's really wonderful to see all of you joining every day and adding your energies to this wonderful group. On behalf of the CEO Quanta Foundation, I wish to thank all the donors who have contributed between 9th October to 15th October. Our immense gratitude to all the donors. I also want to thank all the donors contributed for our upcoming 4th issue of Buddha CEO magazine. I would like to announce the names of the people who have contributed for this issue. Sridhar Saraswati, Anil Devata, Anil Ranka, Narendra Babu Paladugu, DLS Shresti, and Arvind Sampath. I also would like to thank all the other donors of contributed for our regular operations, Ramakrishna Akarapu and K. Krishnakant, and I thank all the other anonymous donors. Friends, there is one anonymous donor contributed on 11th October. I request you to share your either Aadhaar or PAN number, because this is mandatory to for our purpose. We have to notify to the department. So I request you to share either Aadhaar or PAN number. So we at Buddha CEO Quantum Foundation are committed to spread this breath mindfulness meditation and spiritual wisdom across the globe. So as you all know, like a small action multiplied by number of people is equal to a big change. So I request all of you to become a partner in this noble cause of spreading this breath mindfulness meditation and spiritual wisdom across the globe. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks, Samson. Wonderful. And how was your meditation today, Nishan?
It was really great. And with so much of powerful affirmations and the group energies are so high. It's really wonderful.
Thank you. Yes. So, yes, thanks. Thank you so much for all the donors. It's really nice to be part of this noble cause. And so you can also do your recurring donation as well. So every month you can contribute something that can help us in, you know, plan, because there are some kind of cost also involved in every part of that, like the Zoom license cost and the softwares that we use. And so there are some costs associated with that. So to meet that, I think the donations definitely will help us, you know, to reach more and more people across the world, right? And when I started donating, I think the first thing is, like, I was just limiting myself. Okay, this is the much, you know, this is my budget, or this is what I should actually, okay, because I have only this. So with that, I think I can actually take the slice of that cake only. And then, but over the time, I think I don't have that limitation. Even I think I experimented that when I don't have that limited, or that when I moved away from that, but somehow that whatever the contribution comes in out of nowhere in my income, somehow that comes, that money, yes, money is also an energy, right? So that comes somewhere. So without my any list in my income list itself, it comes up. So that's a power of, you know, donation. But very important is, I don't actually have that intention of, okay, I'm sharing the wealth somewhere, but anyway, this will come in some other way. No, never. I'm not having that kind of intention, but I'm just feel happy to just the feeling comes up. Okay, I should do something. Okay, let me do that. That's it. So, once I done that, I stayed detached with that. Okay, that's so. Always that kids are like that, right? They feel they achieve something, and then the moment after that, they don't actually, I have achieved something, I did something. They don't actually enjoy, you know, just attached to that old things, right? But so I, in fact, learned that even from my kid as well. Like when they did something, then they come out of that. And then, so same thing, like be part of this noble cause, refer your friends and families as well. It's very, very important. And thank you so much. And so anyone would like to share your experience? Anyone? Yes, I think someone raised their hand. Kavita, ma'am. Okay, so any last sharing of the day today? Any last sharing? Right. So, all right, I think thank you so much for participating, all the participants today, and being part of this manifestation session today. And we'll connect again tomorrow at the same time. It's really great to be part of this. Yes, Vivek, sir.
Yeah, I will put on my video. Okay. Good morning, everybody. My name is Vivek Marathe. I have been associated with this and have been doing meditation quite regularly. I have benefited to a great extent also in control on my mind and all other things. But last few months, I was just not able to concentrate. It was very, very difficult for me to concentrate and meditate. Today, after a very long time, for 1 hour, I could do it without any trouble. So I'm really happy about it. Okay, that's what I wanted to say. I'm thankful to all of you for the selfless service that you are giving to all of us. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful, wonderful. That's the moment, you know, we come out and then share, you know, the first of all, when we wanted to share itself, it is a joy that, you know, okay, yes, I had had a great feeling, and then let me want to share that, you know, to the entire group. That is number one. I'm sincerely thanking and grateful for sharing, you know, your experience today, sir. And the number two is, you are sharing definitely inspire many others in this journey, all the participants. So thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, all the participants, and have a great day ahead. Have a great Sunday. And let's connect back tomorrow at the same time.
This path, may I